Okay. Now, here mole fraction is x2 for the solubility. Now, we'll see the statement of the Raoult's law. Now, what Raoult's law states here? Raoult's law states that partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component here. Now here we can also write here P1 is equal to P1 0 into X1. Let this is statement number 1. Now this is for solvent. Okay. Now this is written for the solvent here. See, what is the Raoult's law? Raoult's law states that the partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component. Or alternatively, the Raoult's law states that the partial vapor pressure of volatile component is equal to product of multiplication, product of vapor pressure of pure component and mole fraction of that component here. This is for solvent. Now for solute, okay, for solute, what do you obtain here? For solute, P2, partial vapor pressure of solute, is directly proportional to X2 here. Or in another word, we can write here P2 is equal to P2 0 into X2 here. In this way, let this is equation number 2 here. Now from this, the statement of the Raoult's law is obtained there. Now see, what is the Raoult's law? Raoult's law states that the partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of that component, or the partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is equal to product of vapor pressure of pure component and the mole fraction of that component here. In this way, Raoult's law is given here. Now see, once again, I am repeating the Raoult's law. The partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component, or the partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is equal to product of vapor pressure of pure component and the mole fraction of that component here. Okay, this is about the Raoult's law here. Now, remember, for solution, what do you obtain here? For solution, now see here, total vapor pressure of solution, that is the P is equal to P1 plus P2, where P1 is the partial pressure of solvent and P2 is the partial vapor pressure of solute. Now this is given according to the Dalton's law of partial pressure. Now see here, last year in the gaseous state, we already discussed the Dalton's law of partial pressure. That is, the total pressure of liquid is equal to sum of the partial pressures of the components of the solution then, or the mixture, components of the gaseous mixture then. Now, from equation 1 and 2, what do you get here? P is equal to, what is the value of P1? Value of P1 is given here. P1 is equal to P1 0 into X1 plus P2 0 into X2 here. In this way, the total vapor pressure of solution is given there. Therefore, this P is equal to, now P1 0 into X1, P2 0 into X2 there. Okay, X2 is given here. But we know that X1 plus X2 is equal to 1. Therefore, X1 is equal to 1 minus X2. Therefore, P is equal to P1 0 into 1 minus X2 plus P2 0 into X2 here. Okay, in this way, we obtain the total vapor pressure of solution according to the Raoult's law here. Now, I am explaining all these points combinedly now. See here, Raoult's law states that partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of that component, or partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is the product of vapor pressure of pure component and the mole fraction of that component. For solvent, partial vapor pressure P1, now pure component P1 0, mole fraction X1. For solute, P2 is the partial vapor pressure, P2 0 is the vapor pressure of pure component, and X2 is the mole fraction here. Now for solvent, we obtain this term according to the Raoult's law. For solute, we obtain this term according to the Raoult's law. Now for solution, total vapor pressure is given, that is P is equal to P1 plus P2. Now by substituting the values of from equation 1 and 2, that is values of P1 and P2 in this equation, we obtain this equation here. But we know that according to this, the x1 plus x2 is equal to 1, that already discussed. Therefore, x1 is equal to 1 minus x2. Now, therefore, P is equal to P1 0 into 1 minus x2 plus P2 0 into x2 here. In this way, the Raoult's law is given for the vapor pressure of liquid there. In this way, the very important point is obtained, that is the Raoult's law for the given components of the liquid here. Okay, now see here, whenever we go through the Raoult's law, now from the Raoult's law, we obtain the given substances, whether they are volatile or non-volatile here. Therefore, we obtain the total vapor pressure of the liquid here. Now see here, from this vapor pressure of the liquid, we having the another part here, that is the certain points are given on the basis of the Raoult's law here. Now, on the basis of the Raoult's law, there are certain points are given there. Now, which points are given related to the Raoult's law? Now, first point is given, that is the ideal solution. Okay, ideal solutions. And second part is given, that is the non-ideal solution. Non-ideal solutions here. These two terms are given, ideal solutions and the non-ideal solutions are given there. Okay, now first of all, what are the ideal solutions here? Now what are the ideal solutions? The solutions which obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration are called ideal solution. Matlab solution ka concentration kitna bhi ho, then also Raoult's law is get obeyed, that is partial vapor pressure of volatile component is directly proportional to the mole fraction here. Okay, now what are the conditions for ideal solution? Now when we mix the two components of the solution. जब हम solution के component mix करते हैं, then delta H of mixing is equal to zero. Okay, and delta V of mixing is equal to zero. See the meaning of this sentence here. Now, what are the ideal solutions? The solutions which obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of the concentration known as the ideal solution. Now, when components of the solution are mixed together, during that delta H of mixing is equal to zero. Now, what is the meaning of this? When the components of the solute, that is solute and solvent, are added, during that heat is not evolved or absorbed. मतलब जब solution के component आप add कर रहे हैं, तो वहाँ पे heat evolve भी नहीं होती या absorb भी नहीं होती. Then it is known as the ideal solution. And one more important point is there. When the components of the solution are added together, there is no change in volume. Means delta V of mixing is equal to zero. Such a solutions are known as the ideal solutions. Now, what are the examples of the ideal solution? Now, see here, N pentane, okay, plus N hexane. These are the example. This is the example of the ideal solution. Or when we consider chloroethane or ethane or bromoethane plus bromoethane. Now they form the solution, that is the ideal solution. Means for the ideal solution, the solutions which obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration known as the ideal solution. And conditions for the ideal solutions are delta H of mixing is zero, delta V of mixing is also zero there. And examples are given there. Now, in case of the when there are N hexane, N pentane or chloroethane, bromoethane are mixed together, they form the ideal solution. Now, second point is given. What about the non-ideal solution? The solution which does not obey Raoult's law over the entire range of concentrations of solution are known as the non-ideal solution. See again, what are the non-ideal solution? The solution which do not obey Raoult's law over the entire range of the concentration are called non-ideal solution. अभी दोनों के बीच में डिफरेंस देखो. Ideal solution obeys the Raoult's law. Non-ideal solution does not obey the Raoult's law here. Therefore, for non-ideal solution, delta H of mixing is greater than zero, or delta H of mixing is less than zero, or delta A, that is delta V of mixing is greater than zero, or delta A V of mixing is less than zero there. Okay, now when such a condition is given, okay, such a conditions are given there. Now when this condition is given here, that is delta H of mixing and delta V of mixing are greater than zero, such a solution shows the positive deviation. वो क्या दिखाते हैं आपको? Positive deviation है. And when delta H of mixing and delta V of mixing, when they are less than zero, then remember this is known as the negative deviation. In this way, the non-ideal and the ideal solutions are given there. Therefore, see, the non-ideal solution, the solution which do not obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of temperature and pressure with entire concentration known as the non-ideal solution. इसका conclusion क्या हुआ है? Ideal solution obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration. Non-ideal solution do not obey the Raoult's law over entire range of the concentration. And therefore, from this we obtain the two points here, that is the positive deviation and negative deviation from the ideal behavior there. Because during the mixing of the component of solution, matlab solution ke component jo aap mix kar rahe, now when these component are mixed together, during that when delta H of mixing is positive, greater than zero, and delta V of mixing is also greater than zero, and now such a solution shows the positive deviation from the ideal behavior. And when delta H of mixing and delta V of mixing are less than zero, that is the negative, such a solutions are known as the negative deviation from the ideal behavior. Now this Raoult's law and the ideal and non-ideal behavior we can show by using the graphical presentation here. We can show the graphical presentation here. Now for the graphical presentation here, now how it is shown graphically here, see this graph we are going to draw here. Now for this here, suppose vapor pressure, यहाँ पे भी हम consider कर रहे हैं vapor pressure. Okay, यहाँ पे क्या consider कर रहे हैं? Mole fraction. No, mole fraction here. Now here x1, अभी यहाँ पे p1 zero, partial vapor pressure of the solvent. Therefore x1 is equal to zero. तो यहाँ तक x1 क्या हो रहा है? x1 is equal to 1, तो यहाँ पे x2 क्या होगा? 1, और यहाँ पे x2 क्या रहेगा? 0. Now here, when we draw the graph here, we obtain such a type of graph here. Now from this also we obtain the this graph here. Okay, now this is the value of p1 0 and this is the value of p2 0 here. This graph is given, and when we join this, so we obtain the p1 plus p2 there. So हमें क्या मिलेगा यहाँ पे? p1 plus p2 there. In this way, the graphical representation from the Raoult's law is given. Now when such a conditions are given there, now for such a conditions of the vapor pressure of the solvent and the solute are given there. Now what about this? When such a conditions are favorable, this is the ideal condition is given there. Now when this ideal condition is given there, but when certain solution, when they show the vapor pressure, that is the upper curve is shown. Now see here, here is the upper curve is shown here. Now here also upper curve is shown here. Now such a solution shows the positive deviation. तो वेपर प्रेशर यहाँ पे इंक्रीज हो रहा है, एंड व्हेन दे शो द सच अ टाइप ऑफ बिहेवियर हियर, देखो यहाँ पे बिहेवियर दिख रहा है. ओके, नाउ दे शोस द नेगेटिव डेविएशन ऑफ फ्रॉम द आइडियल बिहेवियर. इन दिस वे द मोल फ्रैक्शन देन वेपर प्रेशर फ्रॉम द राउल्ट्स लॉ आर कोरिलेटेड देयर, देन दे शो द सच अ डेविएशन फॉर द पॉजिटिव एंड द नेगेटिव. मतलब जब दे शो द अपर कर्व फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल वैल्यू, देन दे शो द पॉजिटिव डेविएशन. व्हेन दे शो द लोअर कर्व, दैट इज द वैल्यू लोअर देन द ओरिजिनल वैल्यू, देन दे शो द नेगेटिव डेविएशन हियर. इन दिस वे देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द आइडियल एंड द नॉन आइडियल सॉल्यूशंस. दिस इज अबाउट द राउल्ट्स लॉ, and this is the condition of the ideal and non-ideal. their solutions here. Okay, now from this Raoult's law or from this vapor pressure here, we obtain the one more point here. Now what is the one more point here? That is the azeotropic mixture. Okay, azeotropic mixtures, or they are known as the azeotropes. Azeotropes or azeotropic mixture. This is the another point is given for discussion here. Okay, azeotropic mixture or the azeotropes are given there. Now when we go through this azeotropic mixture or azeotropes there, what is the meaning of this azeotropes here? See, if you add, that is the water and the ethyl alcohol or ethanol, when they are added together, the water and ethanol, अभी ये दो solution आपने add किए, तो आपको पता है water का जो boiling point it is 100 degree Celsius, okay, and this boiling ethanol having the boiling point near about 60 degree Celsius there. Okay, now they are mixed together. अभी इनको हमने क्या किया है? Mix किया है. Mix करने के बाद जब हम इसको boil करते हैं, दोनों को boil करते हैं, mixture को, not separately हैं, मैं दोनों को mix किया है और दोनों को हम अभी क्या कर रहे हैं? Boil कर रहे हैं. तो पहले क्या होगा? The ethanol get first boil at 60 degree Celsius. As soon as completely ethanol is removed, then we obtain the ethanol separately. Then water will boil at 100 degree Celsius. But certain solution, when they are mixed together, certain solutions when they are mixed together, and after mixing, when they are boiled at a constant temperature, एक ही temperature. अभी देखो यहाँ पे, ये दोनों liquid जो है, अलग-अलग temperature पे boil हो रहे हैं. Though they are present in the single mixture there. But certain solutions when they are mixed together and allowed to boil there. Now during the boiling, these liquids boil at constant temperature, only single temperature. It means that these two liquids are known as the azeotropic mixture, or they are known as the azeotropes here. Let's see again. What are the azeotropes? The mixture of the different liquids, mixture of different liquids when they boils at same temperature, known as the azeotropic mixture or the azeotropes here. In this way, this is the another part is given from the azeotropes there, and which is the important application of the Raoult's law here. And this is all about the Raoult's law. Now in this topic, what we discuss here, Raoult's law state that the partial vapor pressure of volatile component of solution is directly proportional to mole fraction. From this we obtain the one relation that already we derived there. Now further, from the Raoult's law we obtain the two types of the solution, ideal solution and the non-ideal solution. Ideal solution, the solution which obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration. Non-ideal solution do not obey the Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration, means they are applicable only for dilute solution here. Okay, now this is shown by the Raoult's law here. Okay, that is the positive and negative deviation, and last point we discuss the azeotropic mixture. Okay.